Hello everyone, Dr. Sindhu. Today I'm going to tell you about the third trimester of pregnancy. So what are the important things you should know when you're in third trimester of pregnancy and what are the important symptoms and what are the things you should be ready to face when you're in your third trimester of pregnancy and what kind of diet you should eat and what are the tips you can follow to have to increase your chances of having a normal delivery. Yeah. So first and foremost is when you reach 28 weeks, the 7th, 8th and 9th month of your pregnancy is called as third trimester of pregnancy. So between 28 weeks to 40 weeks is your third trimester. So it's a very important and very crucial period of your whole pregnancy because most of the complications do happen in third trimester. And the important thing is, if at all, if any complications happen also, we'll be in a stage where we can do something about it, because till we reach, you know, third trimester, if any unforeseen complications happens, we might not be able to do anything from our side, you know, to safeguard the baby and everything. But once you reach a third trimester, our chances of, you know, taking care of the baby and everything, if any unforeseen complications happens, is more. So it is as a mother and as a pregnant lady, it's your response. There are certain things and certain responsibilities also on your side which you should know when you're in your third trimester. So first and foremost is, so let us just talk about the normal things, what happens in the third trimester. So once you reach your third trimester, your physical and emotional health is very, very important, because your baby is growing inside. So all the other development of the baby is completely done. Now from now onwards, your baby will gain almost 30 grams every day. That means your baby is going to definitely gain 1.5 to 2 kgs more weight than what it is right now, yeah, from your 28th week onwards. So it's very, very important on your part to do whatever possible from your side to nourish the baby, yeah. So first and foremost, take your multivitamins and iron, calcium and vitamin D supplements. It's very, very important. Along with it, watch your diet, yeah. Watch for what you're, you know, consuming. Consume foods which are very rich in iron, calcium, omega-3 fatty acids and vitamin D. I've told in all my videos, there are, you know, very good and humble foods which are very easily available. You don't need any exotic fruits or any, you know, fancy dietitian or somebody to tell you all these things. So these are all normally which are available, which are there in our, you know, in our households, which is easily available, like, you know, all the green leafy vegetables, broccolis, spinach, kale, Brussels, they are all very rich in iron. Eat every day two fruits along, pomegranate, watermelon, they are very rich in iron. So calcium, so drink milk and take buttermilk and yogurt. If you go for your low-fat curd, low-fat milk also, it's definitely fine. They will definitely give you enough calcium and vitamin D required, you know, whatever is required in a day, yeah. And go for this, you know, fortified foods which are, you know, fortified with vitamin D and everything. So omega-3 fatty acids, like, you know, salmons, tofu is a great option for vegetarians, and salmon is a great option for you know, if you are a person who, you know, eats meat and all. So make sure you consume at least one or two servings in a day of all these things to make your body rich in calcium, iron and everything. So calcium and iron is not only for the baby, it is for you also. It is all the nutrients and all the prenatal supplements and everything is to the nourishment of the mother as well, because your body should be nourished enough to nurse the baby once the baby is born, yeah. So and these are the things which will be happening inside the baby. So as when it comes to your thing, you know, when it comes to the mother, first and foremost is drink plenty of water. So your water drinking will definitely have an effect on the water around the baby. So water around the baby is nothing but it's just the baby's, you know, urinary system which is working there. Baby will pass urine, it will drink its own urine, and that is what circulates around as, you know, amniotic fluid. So your water intake will definitely has a direct impact on that. So in the third trimester, it's very important to drink at least 3 liters of water every day. You might be, you know, having this this thing of, you know, peeing very frequently, but it's okay if you are peeing very, very frequently. That's definitely fine. At least, you know, you will not get urinary tract infections, and baby will definitely get good levels of, you know, amniotic fluid around it. So maintaining that level is very, very important in the third trimester. So consume healthy diet, drink plenty of water, avoid lifting any kind of heavy weights or, you know, wearing any high heels and tight fitting clothes. So, and exercise is very, very important. If you don't have any complications like, you know, low-lying placenta or anything like that, you, if your doctor has advised you not to do exercise specifically, other than that, those situations, you should definitely be able to do at least brisk walking. At least 30 to 40 minutes of walking in a day is a must. Yeah, do Kegels exercise. Kegels exercise is nothing but, you know, just when you're sitting, and, you know, working in the office, or when you're, you know, watching TV or something like that, try to squeeze in your perineal muscles. So as I'm talking to you, as you're listening to me, you can, you know, try to do that. Yeah, try to squeeze in your, you know, perineal muscles as if you're, you know, holding your urine from coming out, and hold that position for, you know, 5 to 10 seconds and relax. Again, you hold it for 5 to 10 seconds and relax. So it will strengthen the tone of your perineal muscles. It will definitely help to, you know, stretch during your delivery. It will definitely help the facilitating of the delivery. And you can do some yoga poses and everything. So I have a video which I'm actually preparing for it. You know, what are the exercises you should do in the pregnancy to facilitate the head to descend inside your, you know, pelvic cavity. So you can do squats. Squats is a very simple thing. Yeah, you can definitely do squats to, you know, help the baby's head descend. So these are all the things. Being active, being yourself, you know, keeping yourself active is very, very important if you are aiming, if you're really, you know, willing to have a normal delivery. See, having a normal delivery is important, and it's definitely important to all the pregnant ladies. There's no good way other than having a natural birth, but there are very unforeseen things which happen in the, you know, delivery process. So there are certain situations where it might not be correct, or it might not be inevitable for us to do a normal delivery, but those things and all are always there. But from our side, if we are putting our effort in towards it, our chances of having a normal delivery is definitely more. I'm not saying just because you're going for walking every day and just because you're doing all kinds of exercises, 100% you'll have a normal delivery. But your effort will definitely be having some impact when it comes to the labor process. So the having a normal delivery planning should not happen all of a sudden just 2 or 3 weeks prior to your due date. It should begin from the first day of your pregnancy. From then you should watch your diet, you should be, you know, regularly, sincerely doing your exercise, you should be developing your strength and everything. Okay, so that is an exclusive thing. Okay, I have planned one more video for that, you know, how to prepare yourself for the delivery. Okay, so now we are about talking about the third trimester. So let us, you know, concentrate here. So then this is about your third trimester, what things you should, you know, do as a pregnant lady to overcome any of this complications, you know, and know about your diet and everything. So next important thing is your sleeping position. So second trimester also I told sleeping should be on the left or the right, on the right lateral side, but in the third trimester is all the more important to sleep on your side. A pregnancy pillow is a very good option. It's a very good invention, I guess. So it's definitely helps you sleep in comfort. You should definitely, you know, buy it and, you know, use it. It'll definitely give you a good night's sleep. Having a good rest, having a good sleep is very, very important in the third trimester to keep your overall health good. Yeah, so get a pregnancy pillow and try to, you know, sleep in it. It's a very good option, and it'll help you with the back pain and everything. Yeah, so these are all the things which you should know. So when it comes to the baby, so there are very important things which you should know. First and foremost is watch for the baby movements. So baby movements is never important. It is very, very important in the third trimester. So if you can't keep a track of the baby movements throughout your day, so after each meal, after breakfast, lunch and dinner, so just lie down on your left side and just watch for, you know, 1 hour to 1 to 1.5 hours. In that 1 hour, you should at least feel 3 to 4 movements. Yeah, at least minimum 4 to 5 movements. So if you feel like, you know, 4 to 5 movements in that 1 hour after, immediately after your meal, that's very good. Yeah, that's good enough for us to know whether baby is moving fine. Okay, otherwise also, if you feel compared to yesterday, today I'm feeling less movements, you are the better judge you know, in that, okay, if you feel like, you know, no, compared to yesterday, today I'm feeling less movements, and this is not the same movement which I felt, you know, yesterday. If you have any doubts regarding that, don't even hesitate for a moment, just go straight to the doctor. Yeah, just get the, you know, heartbeat checked and everything. So baby movement is very, very important. Drinking plenty of water is very, very important. Sleeping on your left side or right side is very, very important. And next thing is important things which you should watch for is, if you have noticed any sudden increase in the weight, you should not gain more than 1.5 kgs in a week's time. Yeah, so that's a very rapid weight gain. So rapid weight gain can be due to your, you know, swelling of your legs, feet, and your, you know, face. If you see sudden increase in your size of the feet, and all of a sudden your slippers and all will become very tight, and your eyes are puffy, and if you have headache or blurring of vision, or any heartburn, all these things might indicate towards your preeclampsia or the hypertension, which most commonly develops in the last part of your pregnancy. So if you notice any of these symptoms, immediately you should get yourself checked. It might be a dangerous thing as in preeclampsia also. If you are a diabetic mother, if you are on insulin or any kind of, you know, diabetic diet or whatever it is for you, watching for all these symptoms along with that, watching for baby movements is very, very important. And next thing is, you should get yourself at 36 to 37 weeks, you should get yourself checked for your vaginal infections. Okay, if you have if you happen to have a normal delivery, and if your vagina is harboring any, you know, harmful bacteria, it might have an impact on the baby's health after delivery. So it's important to screen yourself for any vaginal infections at 36 weeks. Okay, so these are all the things which you should know. These are all the danger things which you should know in your third trimester. Yeah, and next thing is, prepare your delivery bag ready by, you know, 34 to 36 weeks. We don't know when the emergency strikes in. See, your due date, only 10 to 15% of the people will deliver on the due date. Most of them will deliver before that, sometimes after that also. Before that, in the sense, your due date is always given at 40 weeks. So by 37 weeks, your baby's complete maturity is done. After 37 weeks, that means 3 weeks prior to your due date, you can get into labor anytime. Okay, so what are the signs of, you know, labor? What are the things you should know, whether is this a labor pain, or is this a normal cramps what you're feeling? So labor pain usually will be, you know, starting, it will be starting from your back, and it will come to your front, and it will go to your thighs, and it will never be continuous. In the sense, the pain will be intermittent. Okay, don't ignore it. Intermittent pain is more dangerous than the continuous pain. Continuous pain might be a false pain also. So when this pain is happening, you might feel your uterus is getting very tight. Okay, in the sense, your uterus will feel like a wood. That is how we explain it. Okay, it will become very tight, and all of a sudden you might not feel the baby movements and everything. So uterus will get very tight, and along with the tightness, if you are feeling the pain and it is intermittent, okay, your uterus is relaxing in between and it is getting tight, so that might be a warning sign. So you need not get this pain only after 37 weeks. You know, if you happen to have a preterm labor also, you can be experiencing these kind of pains. So this kind of pain, anytime if you see in your third trimester, you should be knowing to know the difference. If you are finding it, you know, difficult to understand what's happening, so it's always better to go see the doctor. Okay, there is no problem is silly, or no thing is less important when it comes to third trimester. Anything which feels abnormal, which, you know, your instincts say something is not normal, just head to the doctor. There is nothing wrong in that. Okay, so there is nothing wrong in checking whether everything is okay. So this is how a labor pain will start. Otherwise, if you have any water leaking, some people might, you know, just start leaking the water without having any pain or anything. So immediately if you see water leakage, you straight away head to the doctor. No, there is no way to, you know, wait for the pains to come, or where you might be thinking that, well, immediately after the water breaking, should I go, or should I wait for the labor pains? Nothing doing. If you see any kind of, you know, bleeding or any kind of water leaking or any kind of pain, you should directly go to the doctor. Yeah, so these are the important signs of, you know, things which might tell you that you might be in the early labor. So once you go to the doctor, they might check you and they might say, you know, you are in early labor or you are in advanced labor. So that is a later part. So when you are at home, you should know this is how a labor pain looks, and if there is any water leaking, if you break your water bag, or if you have any, there is a bleeding, in the sense there is something called a cervical plug. Okay, there is a small mucus plug which will block the cervix throughout your pregnancy. After 37 to 38 weeks, you know, it might just, you know, come out. So you will, if you have a doubt whether it is a mucus plug or whether it is bleeding, so that time also you'll have to go to the doctor itself to check. So, but you should know these things can happen in a later trimester of the pregnancy. So I guess that was about your third trimester of pregnancy. Any doubts regarding your third trimester, please comment me below. I'll be more than happy to clarify your doubts. And I'll see you all in the next video. Till then, take care and drink plenty of water. And definitely watch for the baby moments. Bye-bye.